What's up, my nigga?
What's going on, man?
My nigga, this me and my bitch, man, got into it again.
Yeah, bitches.
These hoes, man. I mean, bitch wildin', man. She.
Bitch. She's nothing but a hoe, man.
That's what I'm saying. I'm out here riding, man. I'm here on a spot right here. I'm going to this bitch, man. I'm out backwoods somewhere, man.
There you go, man. You know there's white boys out there.
Dear me, it's been quite a while since we had a chat. You went away. We love you, and we need you back. Over time, it seems you may have lost your way, but hopefully there's still a chance and it's not too late. If this message finds you in time and you're doing well, if you're reading it and you're still alive and not in jail, do something worthwhile and positive, make history. Don't die a mystery. Sincerely, me. Dear me, it's been quite a while since we had a chat. You went away. We love you, and we need you back. Over time, it seems you may have lost your way, but hopefully there's still a chance and it's not too late. If this message finds you in time and you're doing well, if you're reading it and you're still alive and not in jail, do something worthwhile and positive, make history. Don't die a mystery. Sincerely, me. I always considered myself the exception to the rule, that I would never sell my soul to be accepted or be thought of as cool. But that's exactly what I ended up doing, low key. I call my people nigga, and nigga's what they call me. Somewhere along the path, I guess I kinda lost my way. Everybody else was saying it, so I thought it would be okay. I even made up rules like, well, I can say it, cause I'm black. I can sing it in a song, but you can't sing it back. I told myself I took control of the word, jokes on me. Cause I call myself a nigga now, they don't need to say it, B. Negro, nigger, nigga, it's all the same. I identify with this word more than I identify with my own name. But I have to remember where that shit came from though, nowhere nice. These people took me and sold me for a fucking price. They didn't bother to learn my name, instead they gave me this. And I proudly embrace it like it's some kind of gift. But it's not a gift, it's a motherfucking racial slur. Blacks, whites, Hispanics, nobody should use the word. How about instead when we refer to one another, we use a word more appropriate, like, I don't know, brother. Dear me, it's been quite a while since we had a chat. You went away, we love you, and we need you back. Over time, it seems you may have lost your way, but hopefully there's still a chance and it's not too late. If this message finds you in time and you're doing well, if you're reading it and you're still alive and not in jail, do something worthwhile and positive, make history. Don't die a mystery. Sincerely, me. I'm not exactly sure when or where along the road my women stopped being women, became bitches and hoes. But I know I have a son, my son has a mother, and even though we're not together anymore, I still love her. Yeah, we had our issues and I did some things that I regret, but it doesn't make her less than human or undeserving of respect. Her name ain't bitch and it sure ain't ho. And even though we may never be friends again, she needs to know that God put her on this earth to be the cradle of life. And I should have been more appreciative of her. She was my wife. Now I can't turn back the hands of time and try to make it right. It's best to wish her well and to have a happy life. But what I take from that is I needed to show some more respect for one of the greatest gifts from God, the fairest sex. And if I'm lucky enough to ever fall in love again, as God is my witness, I'll be a better kin. For the rest of you men out there stunting and trapping, not only are they not thoughts and holes, we're blessed to have them. And if it weren't for my mother, well, there'd be no me. And for the record, there's no holes in my family tree. Dear me, it's been quite a while since we had a chat. You went away, we love you, and we need you back. Over time, it seems you may have lost your way, but hopefully there's still a chance and it's not too late. If this message finds you in time and you're doing well, if you're reading it and you're still alive and not in jail, do something worthwhile and positive, make history. Don't die a mystery. Sincerely, me. If I could FaceTime my younger self or send a letter, what would I say? probably that I could do better. I've taken a lot of shortcuts and whatnot over the years, made a lot of mistakes, and cried a lot of tears. I've done a lot of things that I probably shouldn't have did. I said a lot of things that I probably shouldn't have said. Honestly, I'm kind of surprised I'm still alive. But here I am, the real me, just trying to survive. I put a message in a bottle, and I let it go. There were some things that needed to be said that I needed to know, like, it's never too late to try, and I'm damn near 50. Change starts from within, it's all about me. So before I tell somebody else how to live or what to say, I gotta read this letter, the fix can break. And when I'm perfect, then maybe I can judge you better. But for now, I just keep writing letters to me. Dear me, it's been quite a while since we had a chat. You went away, we love you, and we need you back. Over time, it seems you may have lost your way. But hopefully there's still a chance and it's not too late. If this message finds you in time and you're doing well, if you're reading it and you're still alive and not in jail, do something worthwhile and positive, make history. Don't die in mystery, sincerely, me. Dear me, it's been quite a while since we had a chat. You went away, we love you and we need you back. Over time, it seems you may have lost your way, but hopefully there's still a chance and it's not too late. If this message finds you in time and you're doing well, if you're reading it and you're still alive and not in jail, do something worthwhile and positive, make history. Don't die a mystery. Sincerely, me.